dating scene is horrible. I've actually had a man tell me that my bipolar disorder and my mental health as a whole is hard to deal with. And we didn't even start dealing with each other. Like, we literally didn't even do anything yet. Like, he literally was like,
you know, I think the reason you're single is because, like, people just don't want to deal with, you know, what you have.
That cut like a knife, like a sword, like that, yo. And I don't even get hurt easily. Like, I'm one of those people, like, I have pretty tough skin and a lot of things don't faze me. That hurt. That really made me think, like, I'm never going to find a man. Like, I'm always going to be lonely. Like, people are always gonna hate me. He really just said that to me. It was a dark-skinned, tall, beautiful man that said that to me. What up, what up, what up, everybody? I am the Mademoiselle, and this is my channel. And today, we are going to be doing a video that I tried to film, like, 20,000 times, and it is, what's up with my mental health? What's up with me taking medication, not taking medication, but most importantly, the reason you guys clicked on this video, what is it like being Black and bipolar? Now, one of the top questions I always get is that, like, what is it like being Black and bipolar? And to be completely honest with you, it kinda is annoying due to social expectations and like a whole bunch of shit that I'm gonna go over in this video. So let me just give you guys a quick little synopsis if you guys are new here. I am the Mademoiselle. My name is Yvana and I have been diagnosed with bipolar and anxiety disorder. I am mixed bipolar and I have a generalized anxiety disorder. So literally shit could just happen to me at any time. Don't know what causes it. It is what it is, okay? And I was diagnosed a couple of years ago. I've been on and off medication. And just to preface, because I know there's gonna be a lot of people who comment this and actually like genuinely grind my gears when people do this, do not shame people for taking medication. When it comes to bipolar disorder, when it comes to schizophrenia, when it comes to a lot of mental illnesses, it's very difficult to manage that without medication. It's very possible, but it's extremely difficult and a lot of people cannot do it. Do not go and put your two cents in and talk about,
oh, medication is bad.
I can say I have a very love-hate relationship with medication. I've been on medication, I've been off medication, and I see the benefits of both, and they're very, very even. I love my drugs, but at the same time, I love to feel like myself. So that is definitely the first side effect, is that you really sometimes can feel very zombie-like, very comatose when you are on medication for a mental illness. So before I get into that, I have to extend on the last point. Like, yeah, do not shame people for taking medication. To be honest, a lot of people don't talk about this, but if you have a mental illness, it gets worse over the years. It genuinely does. If you are going to not be taking your medication when you have a mental illness, you have to really change your lifestyle. You have to eat different. You have to exercise. You have to surround yourself around different people. Do different things. You might have to quit your job because it's too stressful. Therefore, I believe medication is here for a reason. I do not believe in people just demonizing medication. Like, there's a lot of people that genuinely need it, and if they stop taking it, they would not be fully functioning adults. I am a fully functioning bipolar person. I function very well with or without medication, which is really great. My therapist always pride me on that. The only thing for me is I don't do well with change, and I get triggered very, very badly. Now, the thing is, with growing up Black with a bipolar disorder or anything else, people love to throw it around as a joke. That's just normal with the whole joke thing. People are like, oh my God, girl, I'm so bipolar today.
Oh my God, like, damn, you're so damn bipolar.
Oh my God, bitch, did you take your meds? And it's just like, that's not fucking funny. Like, it's really not. Especially when I'm one of those people that actually has a hard time remembering to take my medication. And the only time I remember to take my medication is when I'm on meds for my bipolar disorder. So it's like, if I lash out or I get upset or someone like genuinely does something to piss me off, it really bothers me that people think that's like supposed to be a funny joke. Like,
oh, did you take your meds today? Like, I don't think you take your meds. Like, it's not even that serious.
That's not funny. Like, I'll beat you the fuck up and then I'll blame it on me not taking my meds. Now what? There is definitely a stigma around Black people having mental illnesses. You guys watching this would definitely already know you are seen as crazy. You are seen to be thought of the devil. You are seen as, you know, you don't have it all together, or it's all in your head. You're overthinking. And genuinely, that's not what it is. Most mental illnesses are a legitimate chemical imbalance in the brain. And most of the time you have to do a very, very drastic lifestyle change or be on medication in order to cope with it. There's a lot of people that literally can't work and they're on disability because of their mental illness.
I just realized as I was editing this, I forgot a crucial part about being Black and bipolar that I know everyone can relate to, which is the idea that Black people can't be mentally ill. I've heard this for my entire life and it always pisses me off. And then they'll always say, well, you don't see Black people doing all this crazy stuff in the news like the white people. And it's like, it still very much so happens. Look up Black serial killers, look up Black serial killers or Black crimes that have to do with mental illness. You'd be surprised. They just don't report on it, just like they don't report anything we really do. Honestly, we're like second class citizens to everyone else. But there's plenty of psychotic Black people out there who have done a lot of crazy things in terms of murdering people, hurting people, confessing to crimes they did not commit, pinning crimes on other people that they did commit due to their mental disorders. So before you go and like spew ignorance, please just look shit up. Anyone can be mentally ill and anyone can do really horrible things due to them being mentally ill. Stop going around saying Black people cannot be mentally ill because that is very detrimental. It's absolutely wrong. And most importantly, it's definitely a lie, okay? And don't even sit there in my comment section like, oh, but it's way more white people. No, no. Black people just really don't get reported doing that shit. And Black people also don't really get shown any remorse for their mental illnesses. Like, let's be real, let's think about it. I have a huge theory that everyone who grew up in the hood has an undiagnosed mental illness. This is my personal opinion. That's due to the shootings, the robbings, the extreme poverty in most cases. That's not normal for most people. And most people who grow up in those type of conditions, white, Black, pink, green, will not come out of that situation 100% normal. Okay, I don't care what you say. Okay, you may be this strong, independent, this, that, and the third. Maybe this strong Black man and you overcame all adversity. But I 100% believe that 99.9% of the people who grew up in the hood have something wrong with them mentally. And it's just undiagnosed because they are ignoring it. They believe they can pray it away, or they just genuinely believe that there's nothing wrong with them at all. And I think that's really, really a problem. I believe that's why a lot of us hurt one another. I believe that's why a lot of us go through a lot of shit in terms of social interaction, professional interaction, because we are walking around with all this shit, all this baggage, and all this undiagnosed and unprecedented shit that we just don't account for because we're Black and we can't be mentally ill. So yeah, let me know your thoughts on that down below.
Mental illness is very much real. It is not in everyone's head, but I do agree. There's a lot of people out there that sit there and they like pretend or want to act like they have a mental illness just for attention. And it's like, that's weird and that's annoying and it's genuinely disrespectful. So if you're one of those people, just stop. Like, I personally don't believe in people self-diagnosing themselves with anything. I believe professionals are here for a reason. I really don't like the idea of people self-diagnosing themselves with things without going to professionals. The professionals are here for a reason. Yeah, I understand. Oh my God, some doctors be charging you, da, 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 and a lot of them don't care about you. They just wanna give you meds and not, I get it. But at the end of the day, there are good doctors just like there are good people. There are bad doctors just like there are bad people. I do not think they should be written off. I believe everyone should do their research. And if you genuinely want help, you should go and seek it. There's nothing wrong with going to therapy. There's nothing wrong with taking medication. There's nothing wrong with changing your lifestyle. There's nothing wrong with cutting people off because they're fucking with your mental health. If that's what you need to do, you need to do it. One thing with the Black community that really annoys me with being bipolar is like, people automatically be like, ooh, bitch, you crazy. And it's like, I'll show you crazy in a second. Like, the whole associating being bipolar with crazy just really annoys me. And I have to say that I was definitely guilty of it when I was younger. There was actually a girl that I was dating, like this dude that I had a crush on since I was a kid, but I was never gonna have a chance with because he's like super old. Like, he's probably like 40 now. I'm 25. Like, I had a crush on him when I was younger. Like, I always thought he was like so cute. And he ended up marrying a girl that was bipolar. And I was like, ugh, he wants to go marry a crazy bitch. And I was like 13 or 14 when I said this. And I kid you not, God made me eat those motherfucking words, because when me and my boyfriend broke up a couple years ago and I was like literally at my lowest mentally, I went to my therapist and they basically told me to get on medication. I'd have to go to group sessions. And while I was at the group session, they were like, you don't sound like you're depressed. You sound like you have a bipolar disorder. Like, you're very up and down. Kid you not, I ran away from that diagnosis like a motherfucking plague. I said, no, I'm not. I don't give a fuck what y'all talking about. Y'all don't know what y'all talking about. I went to other places, asked a couple other people, and then I had to really sit, reflect, and think. So that's one thing about being Black and bipolar that like really sucks. Like, you have to really come to terms with it. And then when you come to terms with it, you have to really associate it to your real life. For me, I sat back and I thought about all the people I cursed out for no reason. I thought about all the relationships I suffered. But yeah, all the money I spent, that's another thing. When it comes to bipolar disorder, you will spend a lot of money. Anyone who's bipolar knows this. You spend so much money when you're having like a manic episode. A lot of people also know that you feel really great when you're on a manic episode. But the higher you go, the better you feel on your manic episode, the more you're going to fall. So for me, it was just like, I'm not gonna admit this to myself. Like, I'm just not. So I escaped the diagnosis for a year, and I had a very miserable year until I came crawling back to the same facility and got, you know, diagnosed professionally by someone at the same place. And, you know, I was on medication, then I got off of it, mainly because of the weight gain. And then I got on it again, and then I was on keto, and I was able to lose and sustain the weight. And then now we're in quarantine, and I gained all the weight and lost it again on keto. So like, my weight really fluctuates. And the thing is, when it comes to bipolar disorders, you need to really be mindful of the medication you take, because a lot of it will make you gain weight, and there's also some that will make you lose weight. That sucks. Having to explain this to people, especially your parents. I know you guys are like, do your parents know? My parents don't know that I'm bipolar. My parents don't know that I have anxiety. I actually think I have like ADHD, to be honest. Like, I can't even concentrate. Like, I'm on Adderall. I also start really, really fast, as you guys can tell. When I'm having like a bipolar thing, like I'm kind of like in a manic episode right now, which is horrible because I know I'm gonna fall really bad. But I know for me, I'm very, very self-aware now. So like, I can feel things coming and I know how to manage it better. But like, to be honest, when it comes to most people, I know it's not that easy. I've also realized I can really control my emotions when I'm feeling normal, which is crazy. Like, when I feel like I'm normal, like no depression, no manic, no nothing, I can really control my emotions. Please comment down below if you understand what I'm talking about, because I don't understand what this means. Like, I think I'm gonna have to talk to my therapist about that, because I'm like, it's weird. Like, I could literally cry on demand. I can yell on demand. I could get mad, happy on demand, like just like that. So it's like, that's a little scary, because I was never able to do that before. It was like, my emotions are very, very uncontrollable. So yeah. Explaining to other Black people that I'm mentally ill is annoying, because they're always sitting there like,
oh, you need to go pray. Damn, how does that work with dating?
Oh my God, does everyone else know? Ooh, that's why you act like that.
I'm sorry, was I here to please man? Why is it that mental health or mental illness is not regarded as other illnesses? Like, I don't appreciate that. Like, mental illness is probably one of the worst things you can go through, because it's not anything tangible. Like, yes, it's all in your head, but at the same time, it's not all in your head. You have a chemical imbalance. You are going through a lot and you cannot really control it. You cannot control how you feel a lot of the time when you are going through an episode of whatever it is that you have. So it's like, getting asked those questions are very, very triggering. And it's, when it comes to Black people, it seems to be the question that I get asked the most. Not saying that white people, no, I ain't gonna lie, white people, Hispanic people never ask me those questions. It seems to always be Black people. That's why when it comes to like church, when it comes to like social gatherings where there's a specific amount of Black people, or even when I'm dating, I only mention it when we're serious. I only mention it to a friend where I'm very, very serious with them. I only mention it to someone I'm dating when I'm really, really serious with them. I only really talk about it with people I need to talk about it with. I always end up answering very ignorant questions that make me feel very, very uncomfortable. And it's pretty hard to make me feel uncomfortable. Now, the thing is, now I'm a public figure. Anybody could find this video or any other videos I've done on my mental health, which if you guys wanna see more, I will link down the playlist. Anyone can go and see like the struggles I've been through with my mental health. Like, y'all can see it, from medication to non-medication to bipolar episodes to like, y'all can see it. Like, if you guys go to my most viewed videos, all of them are me in a manic episode, like a full-blown manic. Like, I'm manic right now, but I'm not like that bad, but like, I am. Like, the editing will most likely cut it down and make it look a lot better than what it is, but I'm definitely real, real manic right now. So it's like, my best work comes from me being manic. So it really is annoying to like, say if I'm at a party, you feel me? And it's like, I'm real, real hype. I'm at a business meeting and I'm coming out with loads of ideas. I'm like, well, let's start this business, let's do that. The people are looking at me like, bitch, you crazy, like, calm down, like, relax. It's like, it's hard to explain, like, oh, like, I'm kind of going through an episode right now. So I just usually don't really say much. I just kind of stick to myself and I only explain it to people I genuinely know. The dating scene is horrible. I've actually had a man tell me that my bipolar disorder and my mental health as a whole is hard to deal with. And we didn't even start dealing with each other. Like, we literally didn't even do anything yet. Like, it's not as if, like, we were dating or talking or doing something and, like, we got to something serious. He was like, listen, tap out. Can't do this. Like, he literally was like, you know, I think the reason you're single is because, like, people just don't want to deal with, you know, what you have. That cut like a knife, like a sword, like that, yo. And I don't even get hurt easily. Like, I'm one of those people, like, I have pretty tough skin and a lot of things don't faze me. That hurt, because I was like, damn, like, that really made me think, like, I'm never going to find a man. Like, I'm always going to be lonely. Like, people are always going to hate me. Like, I was like, you really just said that to me? It was a dark-skinned, tall, beautiful man that said that to me. And I really liked him. Like, we had a lot in common. We were vibing. And he literally said he didn't want to date me specifically because of my mental illness. And I understand it can be a lot. It really can. But that really, like, put me, like, it put it in perspective for me, because I was like, damn, like, is this what people with, like, other disabilities feel, like, physical disabilities, is this how they feel? Do they genuinely feel like, damn, no one wants to be with them? Do people really go up to them or say to them in conversation, like, oh, I don't want to deal with what you have, like, that's a lot. That's what goes on. I feel so bad. But if you guys are watching this and you have, like, any type of illness, whether it's a mental illness or a physical illness, or you are disabled, let me know down in the comment section below, because I really want to know. But I'm telling you guys, that hurt. I didn't know what to do. I was like, wow. And I stayed single for like an extra year or two after that. Like, that shit really, like, that put things in a whole nother, like, realm for me. At that point, I was afraid to go out when I had a mental breakdown, or when I just wasn't feeling well, when I was in a manic episode, when I was in a depressive episode. I would literally strictly only go out when I felt normal, which wasn't most of the time. I genuinely sat there and, like, I would withhold it from people. Like, I just wouldn't tell people, like, yeah, I wouldn't tell people I'm bipolar. I would just be me, and if they liked it, they liked it. I realized it is kind of important to tell people you're dating that you're, you know, bipolar or whatever you have, because one, it is a part of you. I know a lot of people like to say, oh, my mental health is not me, dot, dot, dot. But to be honest, it is. It's a huge part of you, and it's a huge part of how you act, especially depending on the severity of it. Like, if you're someone that gets triggered by alcohol, if you're someone that gets triggered by crazy events, if you're someone that gets triggered just by being in a crowd, that's something that people who love you and care about you should definitely know, because they would know how to act accordingly in the situation. It is important to tell people that you have a mental illness, because they should know and should learn as your friend how to deal with it when you're going through something, whether it be an episode, whether it be an attack, or whatever the case may be. It's very important. One thing about dealing with a mental illness and being Black that I really hate is just the pure ignorance, the misunderstanding, and the unwillingness to be different from that. Like, I've had people say a lot of fucked up things to me. I've had people say a lot of, like, demeaning things to me regarding my mental illness, which is why there's a lot of people that just don't know. Like, my family doesn't really know, except for, like, my closer cousins. But other than that, like, I really do keep it to myself. The fear of being judged for your mental illness is, like, really, like, ugh. Especially, you know, what happened to me. Now, the age-old question, am I still taking meds? Why or why not? So I stopped taking my meds involuntarily this time because I had a really shitty psychiatrist that didn't like to answer his phone. So since we're in COVID, there are a lot of offices that are just closed, which does not help those of us who need our drugs, okay? So I decided to go on ZocDoc, which is an app that connects you with a doctor, and a lot of them have, like, Zoom-type meetings, okay? I find me a psychiatrist. You know, cool African dude. He was really, really nice. Funny thing is, my last psychiatrist was also an African dude. And he told me that my anxiety and my bipolar would basically be cured once I got married and had a family. Let that sink in. Now, I know there's a lot of people that be like, oh my God, therapy doesn't work, therapy does work, you just have to find the right therapist. That nigga was very toxic for saying that, like, and I don't really call people toxic often, but that was a very toxic thing to say to me. So I just never went back. So I had another African dude, okay? Very cool. I really liked him. And he gave me a series of medication. He did not only give me medication for my bipolar disorder, he gave me medication for my anxiety disorder. He gave me medication for everything associated with that. So I can't concentrate whatsoever when I'm manic. I had to pop an Adderall to film today. And I feel better, but I think I need to pop a Cyphone to be honest. And he gave me medication to sleep. He literally gave me like 5 to 6 drugs. Now I was sitting there like, this is ridiculous. I do not want to fucking sit here on drugs all my life. But to be honest, I was like, become a more productive member of society. I hit out all my goals. I do what it is that I've always wanted to do with no crazy things happening to me in terms of like me going through mental attacks or like me just being unmotivated because I'm having a depressed day. So I was like, you know what? I'm going to be up to it because I've never had it happen like that. Usually I've been on 1 to 2 medication. I've been on hydroxyzine forever for my anxiety. And in terms of my bipolar disorder, I've been on like numerous medications. I have not found that right medication yet. The only one I could say that really helped was clonazepam. That was the one that helped the longest and had like the least amount of side effects. I've only been on like one. He put me like on 2 for 2 for everything. Like 2 anxiety, 2 bipolar, and then like 1 to 2 for like other side effects that I had. Cause a lot of the medication he gave me doubled for other stuff. So I was like, oh my God, this is great. Started taking the medication. Tell me why this medication made me go blind. I'm not joking. By like a week of me taking the medication, my eyes started to blur. And I was like, okay, I work in social media. I'm always looking at my phone. You know, I watch a lot of TV. So I started to like decrease my screen time and my eyes got progressively worse to the point where I was driving and I couldn't fucking see stop signs. So I was like, okay, this is not good. This is not safe. Oh my God. So I started really thinking like, what the fuck have I changed? And I was like, duh, Yvana, the medication. Hit him up. He's not answering. He gave me his email, he gave me his phone number, but with all due respect, no, he only gave me his email, but I think I copied the email down wrong, so I scheduled another appointment, which took freaking forever. We talk on the phone, he's like, didn't I give you my email? I was like, man, I think it was wrong, because I did send an email, but no one responded. He's like, okay, here's my phone number and my email. Prescribed me the same medication, well, I had the same medication, but he was like, okay, so I want you to take this medication like one at a time. So we're gonna take this for like a couple weeks, see how this works. We're gonna just introduce them slowly to see what's causing you to blurry vision. So he basically told me to take one medication and see how I felt, and that one automatically gave me blurry vision within like a week. So I emailed him, I texted him, absolutely no response. And I'm just like, this has to be a fucking joke. This can't be real. And I got mad and I got frustrated, so I just never went back. So I stopped taking medication. I didn't go back to him. I am in the process of finding a new therapist. I found someone else, but she doesn't take my insurance, and I don't want to have to go through the process of like doing the paperwork. And yeah, that's that. So I'm no longer on drugs, and yeah. It is ridiculous. Like, I was highly upset, and I'm actually still upset about that, because it was like, you gave me your number, I texted it, you gave me your email, I emailed it, it was the right email and the right number, because nothing bounced back, and you did not respond. Like, that's just ridiculous, it's irresponsible, and it's just, like, unreliable as fuck. So, I mean, I was thinking about giving him a third chance, but nah, I think I'm just gonna find someone else. I'm gonna try to go for a black woman this time. I don't know, I'm gonna try to find someone else, because it was just way too much. The whole pray it away thing is annoying. I don't appreciate people just spewing their beliefs on people. I don't like the fact that all black people automatically think that all black people believe in God. I don't like the fact that a lot of black people automatically think that anything that is not normal or anybody that has like a slight difference to them is of the devil or is just not praying enough. Like I hate that. It pisses me off. I hate when people throw Bible verses in my comments. I hate when people go and try to tell me to pray. It really bothers me. Like it genuinely does, because at the end of the day, I know what I'm doing for myself and I understand that yes, God is powerful, the universe is powerful, whatever, I get it, but I have to do things within me and I have to change. I can pray all the fuck I want. If I don't get my life right, it don't matter. I've always been that type of person. So it's like when people try to tell me, oh, pray it away, do this, like it really just bothers me. It's like, first of all, that's why you're still broke, that's why you're still miserable, and that's why you still ain't got no nigga, that's why niggas is still dogging you, that's why you still ain't shit, that's why that wig still look like that, because you want to sit there and think you could pray things away. Point blank period, you cannot pray things away, you have to put in action as a person. I do not believe God, the universe, Allah, Gandhi, whatever. I do not believe people, entities, or beliefs are your entire road to success. I believe you as a human has to do your part. If you don't do your part, your life will fall apart. Okay, period. Like, I do not believe in people just praying things away. I believe you have to put action. Prayer is a secondary thought. I believe prayer is like the seasoning, okay? You have to make the dish before you put the seasoning. Can't just put seasoning on the damn plate. That's the way I see it. So it's like when people try to tell me, oh girl, just pray. Like, bitch, no. Like, I want solutions to do better for myself. Like, I wanna know what you've done, what you know has helped other people in terms of their bipolar disorder. Did they do a specific diet? Did then they do a specific lifestyle change. And I feel like it's very, very dismissive, and it's very disrespectful for those who don't believe in God. There's nothing wrong with not believing in God. Some people really just have different beliefs, and that's okay. With that being said, let me know down in the comment section below, do you have a mental illness? How do you cope? And if you are a Black person watching this, let me know what it's like for you being Black and having a mental illness. Do people treat you differently, better or worse? What is it that you do in those situations when people do treat you differently? And also let me know what you think is better, medication or non-medication, why or why not. With that being said, make sure you guys like, share, subscribe, do all that, and I'm gonna see y'all next time.